Your spirit is the Holy Spirit. Did you hear that? You don't have a different spirit outside Holy Spirit. There's nothing like my human spirit and Holy Spirit. Are you a monster? How can you carry two spirits? You only have one spirit. What is the name of that spirit? Holy Spirit. So you and God are one spirit. You are what you are. You don't have. You are one. You are. You and God are one spirit. What is the name of that spirit? Holy Spirit. The spirit at work in you, what is the name? Holy Spirit. Because you're born of God. So if you're born of God, what is in God is in you. What is in God? Spirit. What is in you? Spirit. That which is born of spirit. He didn't say that which is born of spirit has spirit. He didn't say that which is born of spirit has spirit. No. That which is born of spirit is spirit. One spirit. The Holy Ghost is called the Spirit of Truth. He is the Paracletos or the Paraclete. That means he's the teacher. Okay? Helper. Counselor. That means right now you have counselor. You have a helper. You have teacher. So you can't be in a situation where you don't know what to do. No. The believer always knows what to do. Say, I know what to do. Shout it loud. I have direction. Say, I have direction. I know what to do. No matter how confused a situation, I know what to do. Because my spirit knows all things. I'm not confused. I know what to do. Because my spirit knows all things. What is my spirit? The Holy Spirit. Religion can't take that. Galatians 2:16. Knowing that a man is not justified by the works of the law, but by the faith of Jesus Christ. Even we have believed in Jesus Christ that we might be justified by the faith of Christ, not by the works of the law. For by the works of the law shall no flesh be justified. No flesh. You are justified by the faith of Jesus. And that faith came by hearing the message of Christ. You heard the message. You opened your heart. The message entered. When the message entered, Christ entered. When Christ entered, faith entered. So that entrance is your birth. And that birth is not a feeling. You don't have to feel anything. It's a knowing. 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 Did you see that? Did you see nervous? Knowing. Not feeling. Knowing that a man is not justified. You have to know you're justified. Not to feel. And that knowledge affects what Christ has done in your life. Yeah. It affects it. It sets it in motion. Born of the Spirit. I'm born of the Spirit. I'm born of the Spirit. I thought somebody would say it. Yeah. I have the life of God. Hallelujah. Romans chapter 6 verse 4. Therefore, we are buried with him by baptism into death. That like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father. Even so, we also should walk in the newness of life. That place is not talking about water baptism. What he's talking about there is that when you received Jesus, you were baptized into Christ. Yes. That salvation is baptism. It's not the water. The experience of Christ in you is baptism. Yeah. Receiving Christ is baptism into Christ. It's not like going to the river and soaking you in water. No. I told you in the beginning, water is symbolic. Did I say so? So water there is a metaphor. Water there is figurative. It's figurative of a spiritual reality that takes place on your inside. You are born or baptized into Christ. That is, you are soaked inside Christ. Baptism means immersion. That is, you are immersed into Christ. That is, your identity ceases to function. You have taken on a new identity. That identity is that from now you are Christ's. You are now Christ's. Christ's. You are buried into Christ. So you are Christ's. You are buried in. You are Christ's. When people see you, all they see is Christ. And if you be Christ's, then are ye Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. What promise? Promise that Abraham should be the heir of the world. Yeah, you're an heir of that promise. That Abraham owned the world. You too. You own the world. Because you are Christ. Somebody say, I am Christ. No, I didn't say I am Christ. I am Christ. That is important. You are Christ. That is, you are baptizing to him. So you are him. You are him. You are in him. He is in you. No difference between two of you. No difference. If he's glorified, you are glorified. If he's righteous, you are righteous. If he cannot fail, you cannot fail. Because you and him are one. Regeneration to give life. Verse 13 of the same Romans. Neither yield your members as instruments of unrighteousness unto sin, but yield yourselves unto God as those that are alive from the dead. You are already alive, and your members as instruments of righteousness unto God. Ephesians 2:10. For we are his workmanship created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God before ordained that we should walk in. We are the handiwork. We are the handiwork of God, sourced in Christ. Created in Christ means the raw material that was used to create this you that is called the new man was scooped out of Christ. Pastor, please. Let me show them something for purpose of concept and understanding. This is Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus. God decided to get children out of Christ. To get what? Because Jesus is the prototokos. That's the Greek word for prototype. Sample. Model. God punished the devil. So, since Jesus is the prototokos or the prototype, God decided to bring out children in Christ. So, what did God do? God sought for raw materials inside Christ. The material he brought from Christ, he used it to form you. So, you are created in Christ. You didn't hear that. That is the creation took place inside Christ. So, you are Christ's. And because you are created in Christ, the creation is unto good works. That means you are now a product of good works because everything in Christ is good. Created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that everybody that is created in Christ should walk in them. That our walk should be a walk in good works. We are not producing good works to be in Christ. We are created in Christ. That is why, because of where we came out from, we produce good works. We don't produce good works to be in Christ. No, it is because we came out of Christ. So because we are created in Christ, the natural response that follows us is good works. We don't do good works by effort. We do good works naturally. And spirits don't die. If any man be in Christ, in the new man, in Christ. If any man be in Christ. Shato. Ephesians 4:24. And that you put on the new man after God is created. We are in righteousness and so, kibatukaba. The raw material that has been used to fabricate the new man, which was sourced out of Christ. What are the raw materials called? Righteousness and... So when you walk, what is walking? Righteousness. When you walk, what is walking? True holiness, not fake holiness. So if there is true, it means there is fake. Which one is fake? Long gown. Which one is fake? No earring. Which one is fake? No scarf. That is fake holiness. True holiness is what God has done in the new man. True holiness is in the heart. In the Old Testament, it was outward appearance. In the New Testament, we are the circumcision that worship God in the spirit and have no confidence in the flesh. Philippians 3:3. Say, I hear. Sit down. Somebody shout, I'm born of God. In righteousness and true holiness. In righteousness and truth. The new man is after God. Is after God. The drive of the new man is after God. He may make mistake, but he won't sit there. He will stand up because his drive is not after mistake. His drive is after God. That is why even when you do bad as a new man, you are not comfortable. Because that is not your environment. And you will not be happy till you get back to your environment. Where is the environment of the new man? After God. Only a man that is not born of God will make mistake and be happy. In fact, let me tell you, even when a born-again child of God sin, he has no pleasure in the sin. To know that you're a child of God is that God takes the pleasure out of sin. Where an unbeliever will do it and be happy with chocolate and tea. You, a Christian, if you do it, your heart will be beating very fast. You'll be sweating under air conditioner because you know that you have moved into an environment that is not your own. When a pig fall inside mud, does the pig spread a table and be happy? Yes. Because mud is the environment of a pig. But when a sheep put his leg inside mud, the sheep will start crying until they bring it out, because that is not the environment of the sheep. When you are born of God, you have no pleasure in sin. You may sin, but you won't stay there. You will jump out, because the new man is after God. Desire of the new man is after God. And that you make mistake doesn't mean you are not a new man. Remember, it is not the good works that created you in Christ. You are first of all created in Christ, then you do good works. So if after your creation you don't do good work, it does not change the fact that you are created. It just means you are acting beside yourself. The Greek word is paralegismo. You are pretending to be who you are not. You are acting up. When you are born again and you lie, you are not a liar. You are a pretender. You are pretending to do what you are not. What you are not. Any wrong thing you do after you are born again is a pretense. That's not you. You are acting beside yourself. You are acting beside yourself. So you better come back to your senses and act yourself. Remember, from the first day we've been trying to answer a question. Can a Christian lose his salvation? That is what I am still answering till now. And I've not yet arrived at the answer. But you must have been answering it now. Thank you, Lord. What a way to answer a question. Your teacher asks you a question. You tell him, sir, sit down. We need to answer it for 30 days. That must be a very serious question. Amen. So regeneration means you start again with the life of God. To start again with the life of God. Now, not what Adam had, but what you now have is called eternal life. Adam didn't have that. Church, look at me. Adam never had eternal life. Never. What life did Adam have? He had human life. God gave Adam human life. For Adam to have eternal life, Adam has to make a choice for Christ. When Adam should have made the choice for Christ to have eternal life, Adam rejected Christ and went for eternal death. So Christ died to redeem the state of man. So today, as a man with physical life, you need to receive Christ to have eternal life and be free from eternal damnation. So anybody not born again is a walking corpse. He's dead, even though he's walking. Because no life until Christ comes. I am come that you may have life.